हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ मोहसिन मुल्ला एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस वीडियो लेक्चर। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द सेकंड यूनिट ऑफ पावर सिस्टम एनालिसिस और पावर सिस्टम टू, दैट इज़ लोड फ्लो एनालिसिस। सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो लेक्चर पर्टिकुलरली वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट लोड फ्लो सोल्यूशन, वट इज़ द नेसेसरी ऑफ लोड फ्लो सोल्यूशन, एंड ऑल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू सी इन वॉट वे द बसेस आर स्पेसिफाइड इन अ पावर सिस्टम। ओके, सो बेसिकली लोड फ्लो सोल्यूशन इज सोल्यूशन ऑफ द नेटवर्क अंडर स्टडी स्टेट कंडीशन। ओके, सो लोड फ्लो सोल्यूशन इज द सोल्यूशन ऑफ नेटवर्क अंडर स्टडी स्टेट कंडीशन, अंडर स्टडी स्टेट कंडीशन सब्जेक्ट टू सर्टन इनइक्वालिटी कंस्ट्रेंट्स, सब्जेक्ट टू सर्टन इनइक्वालिटी कंस्ट्रेंट्स, ओके, अंडर विच द सिस्टम ऑपरेट्स, अंडर विच द सिस्टम ऑपरेट्स। सो दिस इज वॉट इज द लोड फ्लो सोल्यूशन। वी बेसिकली वी नीड टू डिटरमाइन द सोल्यूशन ऑफ ए नेटवर्क अंडर स्टडी स्टेट कंडीशन, ओके, विच आर सब्जेक्ट टू अ सर्टन इनइक्वालिटी कंस्ट्रेंट्स अंडर विच द सिस्टम इज बींग ऑपरेटेड। सो वॉट आर दिस कंस्ट्रेंट्स हियर? सो कंस्ट्रेंट्स कैन बी, ओके, सो द डिफरेंट कंस्ट्रेंट्स हियर आर नथिंग बट द nodal voltages, then reactive power. Okay, so because when the generator is generating active power at the same time is also generating the reactive power, then also there will be changes in the tap settings of transformer. Okay, so tap settings of underload transformers. Okay, so these are you can say such type of conditions are called as the constraints on the system. So under these constraints, whatever network is being operated, so to solve that network, so solving the network is nothing but if in a particular network we know certain quantities and we need to determine some other quantities, so in that case it is called as the solution of a network. Like for example, if the total generated voltage you can say at the sending end is known, and we want to determine the voltage at the receiving end, and also we want to determine the you can say overall power you can say transmitted, so it is nothing but the solution of the system. We are going to consider the different parameters of the system in place, and then we are going to use the equations to support that system to determine the required quantities, or you can say unknown quantities of the system. So basically there will be four different quantities in the system that can be calculated. So one is the real power, then reactive power, then the voltage, and the phase angle of the voltage. Okay, so those are the mainly quantities which we need to determine in a given system. So out of these different four quantities, any two quantities will be given at a time, and other two quantities are to be determined. So for that we need to solve the network equations, and that network solution of the network equations is nothing but called as load flow solution. Okay, so this load flow solution for power network can be worked out both ways according to as it is operating under the balanced or unbalanced condition. So it can be started from receiving to sending end, and or it can be from sending end to receiving end. So in either way it can be calculated, because the system considered is a balanced, and also we can use sometimes the unbalanced conditions. So in that way it can be determined in both the ways. Okay, so here basically what we need to do is load flow solution of the power system requires, okay, so let us just write a load flow solution of a power system requires okay, so first of all it requires formulation formulation or the network equations. And the second thing that it requires is suitable mathematical technique for the solution of the equations. Okay, so this is what we are gonna do in case of load flow analysis. So we are going to develop the network equations, then we are going to use different you can say mathematical techniques to solve these network equations to determine the required quantities here. So two quantities will be basically specified and other two quantities we need to determine here. And since we are studying the system under steady state conditions, so the network equations will be in the form of simple algebraic equations. And here the load and generations are continuously changing in the real power system, but here we are going to assume that the loads and the generation are fixed at a particular value over a suitable period of time. So like for an hour the load does not change and power does not change, that is what we are going to assume here. But practically that is not the case, but for the simplicity of the you can say solution of the equations or for understanding that overall analysis here, we need to consider that constant conditions. Okay, so now how does the bus is classified here? Okay, so here bus classification, let me just write the heading, bus classification. So based on what quantities are mentioned at that particular bus, so the bus can be classified into different three types basically. So here what happens is, basically what is a bus? Bus is nothing but it is a node, okay, so which is associated with four quantities. Okay, so let me just write, in a power system each bus or junction, bus or node is associated with four quantities. Four quantities which are real, reactive power, real and reactive power, then bus voltage magnitude, and its phase angle. Okay, so basically these are the four quantities which are specified at a bus or node. Okay, so in a load flow solution, two out of the four quantities are specified and the remaining two are required to be obtained. Okay, through solution of the equations. That is what we need to do here. Okay, so depending upon which quantities have been specified, the buses are classified. And so here, depending upon which quantities are specified, the buses are classified in the following three categories. First one is load bus. Okay, so at this bus, real and reactive components or powers are specified. Okay, so it is required to find the magnitude of voltage. Here it is required to find the magnitude of voltage and phase angle, and its phase angle. Okay, so two quantities are specified and other two quantities are to be obtained. Similarly, next is called as generator bus or voltage controlled bus. Voltage controlled bus. So at this particular node or bus, so again two quantities are specified here. So two quantities are, one is the magnitude of the voltage and other one is the real power. So here magnitude of the voltage corresponding to, and I'll just write, and the real power generated are specified and it is required to find reactive power and phase angle. Reactive power and phase angle of the bus voltage. Okay, so similarly we need to we have another bus which is called as a slack bus. So in your competitive examination, so you will get question on this classification of the bus. So they will ask you the various quantities specified on the various category of the buses. So you need to select the proper you can say option, depending upon which is matching with the given correct you can say quantities. So here it is, slack bus is also called as swing bus or also called as reference bus. Okay, so here voltage magnitude and phase angle are mentioned. Voltage magnitude and its phase angle is specified and it is required to determine to find real and reactive powers. Real and reactive components of the power. Okay, so here we can summarize totally what we are describing here. So let me just write the summary here. So heading, I'll write the bus type, then quantity is specified. Quantities to be obtained. Quantities to be obtained. Okay, so here the quantity specified. So here bus type say load bus. So what are the quantities specified here? So P and Q, that is real and reactive power, and which quantities are to be determined? Magnitude of the voltage and the phase angle delta. Similarly, next is the generator bus. So at this generator bus, real power and the magnitude of voltage is specified, and we have to determine the reactive power and delta. And in case of a slack bus, so magnitude of the voltage and the phase angle delta is mentioned, and real and reactive power are to be determined. So this is what we can understand from this particular overall. So when we are obtaining the network equations, so basically, so this depending upon what type of node bus is given, so some of the quantities will be known and other quantities are to be obtained. Suppose if the load bus is given, so we'll come to know real and reactive power, and we have to solve the equations to obtain the that voltage and the phase angle. Okay, and usually whatever the phase angle of the load bus voltage is given, so that will act as the reference. Okay, so that will be acting as the reference, therefore that bus is also called as the reference bus. Okay, so that will be considered as the reference quantity. Okay, so therefore that bus is also called as the reference bus here. So basically the whatever equations are going to be obtained, so these equations can be obtained either in the voltage variable parameter or current variable. Okay, so but here since we are going to use the computer techniques to solve the different equations, so from the point of view of the memory and computation time, so it is it has been seen that the node equations are lesser compared to the whatever loop equations we get from the network equations if we are using the current as variable. So therefore, if you are using node voltage as the variable, then the number of equations are less, hence the computational time as well as the memory required is also less. Therefore, we are going to consider the nodal voltages as the independent variables in the most economic way here. So we are going to develop the equations in terms of that node voltages. Okay, so in the next video lecture, we are going to see how we are going to develop the node equations and what are the various you can say basic equations required in order to develop that. Okay, so till then, happy learning and thank you.